The paragraph controls are controls you can use to take controls of your paragraphs as they bridge the gap in between two pages. For example, at the bottom of the first page, I have the first line of my paragraph, and because I can't fit the rest of the paragraph at the bottom of the first page, it spills over into the top of the next page. If I want to control that so it doesn't split like that, well, instead of using a paragraph control, I could come up here, click before it, hit enter, and add an extra line to push it down to the top of the next page. But the problem that you potentially run into is that if I come up here on the first page and add more text here so it pushes this paragraph down and these two lines to the top of the next page, then I have those two blank lines in between that paragraph and this paragraph, and that looks odd. So instead of doing it that way, let me go ahead and hit undo. I can use one of the paragraph controls. Let me right-click within the paragraph and go down to paragraph. Come up here, click on line and page breaks tab, and I'm going to be going over these four controls in the pagination section. First of all, the widow and orphan. The definition of a widow or orphan is that, well, for the orphan, it's the first line of the paragraph by itself at the bottom of a page. So here I have a lonely line in the paragraph at the bottom of this page, that's an orphan. To reverse that, let me go ahead and delete some text above, I'll undo it later, is that if I have the last line of the paragraph at the top of the next page, then that's known as a widow. In other words, Microsoft sees this as you having a line by itself either at the top of the next page or at the bottom of the first page as something that probably isn't really helpful to the reader, because if I read at the bottom of this page the part of the sentence here, and when he does, how does God respond in, and then I go to the top of the next page and I'm like, what did I just read again? I can't simply go back here. I have to go to the bottom of the first page and then to gather my thoughts again and then come back here, and hopefully I flip the page fast enough to continue on with that thought. So instead of having a single line by itself, to overcome the widow or orphan issue, it requires two or more lines, because usually within two lines, you typically have a complete sentence, or at least enough text to gather some sort of idea of what you're reading about without having to flip back and forth between the pages here. So let me go ahead and right-click within the paragraph, go down to paragraph, and check the box widow/orphan control. Now when you check it, it can detect whether you have an orphan or a widow. And because the last line of the paragraph is at the top of the next page, it's the widow, so when I click OK, what it does is it says, OK, I don't want it by itself, so I'll take the next line of the paragraph at the bottom of the first page and bump it down, okay? So that's why it's easier when I transition from here to here, and if I forget part of it, I can continue on, and chances are I'll pick up and have an idea of what I'm reading without flipping back to the next page. And then let me go ahead and hit undo. And hit undo again. So now we have the first line of the paragraph by itself at the bottom, which is the orphan. Right click, go to paragraph, check the same box, it'll know what to do, click OK, and because it can't take the next line and cram it up here because there's not enough space, it just decides, OK, we'll just take this line and put it over to the top of the next page, and coincidentally the whole paragraph's together. Okay, let me go ahead and hit undo. Okay, for the next example, let me go ahead and turn on my codes, come up here on the Home tab to the paragraph group, click on the Show Hide Codes. And let me go ahead and hit enter and type in just any text. Now the next example, the paragraph control, is that if you want to keep one paragraph with the next paragraph so it doesn't split like this, then go ahead and I'm going to right click in this first paragraph, go down to paragraph and check here, keep with the next paragraph, keep this paragraph with the next one. Click OK, pushes it down, you get your code here, this little square that says something's going on with this paragraph. And we know that it's keeping this paragraph with the next one. So anytime it wants to split, it won't between these two paragraphs because they'll be kept together, okay? Let me go ahead and hit undo, and let me go ahead and delete this here. The next control, let me right-click and go back to paragraph, is to keep lines together. When I check that, it's going to keep this line with the next line. We're not talking about widow or orphan controls. It just says, okay, within this paragraph, you want to keep this line with the next one. Go ahead and check it, click OK, and it bumps it down. There's the code that says, hey, something's going on with this paragraph. It uses the same code, that square, and the only way that you can find out what's being applied to it is right-clicking within the paragraph, going to the paragraph, and seeing which box is checked, keep with next or keep lines together, okay? Then I can go ahead and uncheck that, click OK, and it removes that control. And then finally, you have the page break before, meaning that this paragraph, if it ever splits, I always want the page to break before it. So if I go ahead and right-click, go down to paragraph and check, put a page break before it, click OK, it breaks it and dumps it onto the next page. In fact, let me scroll down here and try another one. How about This is Glenn? Right click that title, go to paragraph, say page break before and click OK. So what's interesting is that you see the text above? If I go ahead and I click before it and I hit enter because I want to be able to type some more text, remember the code that's tied to this paragraph says that it can't have anything before it right within that paragraph, it's got to do a page break before. So when I hit enter, it actually added another break, the page break here, in addition to the one at the bottom of this page here. So let me go ahead and hit undo, and because I don't like page breaking before like that, at least if it doesn't make sense. But it does if I have a title here where I don't want this at the bottom of any page or in the middle of any page. I always want that to be at the top of the next page. Thanks for watching. Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel to get notified of the latest videos. And for great specials on my products, please see the description below this video.